The Deputy Inspector General of Government, Antoine Mugisha Muhaire, started her impromptu visits from Kasanda Health Center 4, where she was overwhelmed by the huge stock of expired drugs, especially ARVs. She put the store manager and district health officer Lawrence Ntamu to explain why they let drugs expire in their stores while other districts are struggling with the deficit of medical supplies.
This month you have 4 sacks, okay? Don't you think that's too much? Or by now you should know this health center needs this amount of drugs so that they don't give you much more than you can consume. Because there are certainly other areas that need these drugs.
And unfortunately, they are not consumed. Either people have, you know, don't turned up, or they have migrated, or they have gone to other places. So we have a lot of, you know, missed appointments. So they end up making these drugs get expired.
Muhaire proceeded to other departments where she discovered that patients are asked to buy drugs from outside, yet the same medicine is expiring in the facility store. She directed the arrest of 2 medical workers in the laboratory of the Health Center 4, including Joeliana Kabuye and Edward Mugasa, who were accused of extorting money from patients to get blood tests.
Why do you ask for money? The people you're asking from are very poor.
Muhaire saved the 18-year-old mother who lost a child in the same facility due to recklessness. She was in a direct state of rotting in the womb with no serious treatment. She directed for an instant referral to Mitiana Hospital.
The medication that you asked the patient to buy has been in stock for 4 months.
Yes.
And you say you didn't know.
Yes, I didn't know.
And you are the medical superintendent.
At the back of my mind, the custodian of the drugs has been telling me the drugs are out of stock.
So who should be punished? Because you are the supervisor. Who is
yes,
the supervisor?
I'm the supervisor.
And you at one point you were saying medication came yesterday.
I admit it is my fault. But I request for an excuse. So just for today, I would never do it again.
The husband, Dewo Kiwanuka, who is the same age group, noted that they had spent over ₦1 million on treatment and sold everything back home. It was found out that the 3 types of medicine which medics had prescribed to this young mother to buy outside was in plenty in the medical store of the health center. But the in-charge, Dr. Johnson Kabozibu, feigned ignorance.
We're going to take action even for their supervisor, the in-charge. The unfortunate bit is that we will not arrest him now because he's the only doctor on duty. If you arrest him, then what happens to the other patients? But he also have to answer at one point.
The IGG was shocked to discover that patients were being sent away from getting blood tests at the health center and rather referred to the nearby private laboratory, which was discovered to be belonging to the laboratory technician of the same health center, Edward Lugasa.
Look at the person you extorted money from. What are we doing against the government? Oh no, let that.
On storming the private lab called Elved Medical Laboratory, the deputy IGG discovered government reagents and other supplies. Lugasa had nothing to say but to cry for forgiveness from the IGG.
The proximity of this clinic to the hospital is questionable. How could you have seen that? How can you let your staff have a clinic a stone throw away from the general hospital? What do you expect?
I'm not the person who authorizes people to open up clinics in Kasanda District local government. Me, I was entrusted with the facility, and I've never known that this gentleman has a private clinic besides government
so,
one. It is not me.
What master should I have on you? Your boss is here, he's framing ignorance. He doesn't know that you're here.
Yeah, you don't.
Muhaire grilled the in-charge of the health center for looking away as government drugs are siphoned out by the facility staff to their private clinics. She ordered for an arrest and interdiction of Lugasa.
Police, conclude investigations and let this man be charged, okay?
Madam.
In the courts of law, as soon as possible.
Madam, I'm pleading with you.
So angry. Can you imagine? This is the supervision and accountability that we talk about. The hospital is just a thrown through to this clinic, and someone doesn't know the man owns a clinic where he puts all the NMS drugs.
The chief administrative officer of Kasanda District, Jessica Ndagire Nsobia, wondered why the recent salary enhancements of scientists has helped to restore sanity in public health facilities.
To me, it has that it impacted, it caused some little bit of change. You know, with service delivery, it is about attitude.
The deputy IGG, who was caught up by the night at the Kasanda Health Center 4, proceeded to inspect Kiganda Health Center 4 and Mityana General Hospital, where she found better services. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.